Hi, welcome to this Accofina tutorial on financial calculator tips and guides. We're talking about the time value of money and what all those main buttons mean and do. Okay, the most common function of financial calculators is using the time value of money functions and buttons. Now, these are the five prominent buttons that allow you to calculate present value, future value, payments and cash flows, the number of periods, or even the interest rate. These five buttons are the main reason why people buy financial calculators in the first place. Okay, so here's the key idea. Any question you're asked in a test will give you or allow you to deduce four of the five inputs. And then you'll use the calculator to compute the missing fifth value. And there's your answer. So there are five inputs. And if you have four, you can calculate the fifth. And the question will give you the four or allow you to work out the four. And we're going to go through two live examples to explain everything after this slide. And there'll also be a bonus tip about how to avoid the dreaded error five. Okay, so here are the examples we're going to go through in live demonstrations. We're going to calculate the monthly mortgage payments on a 30-year, $300,000 loan that has a 5% annual interest rate. The second example is we're going to work out how many years to save up for an $80,000 car if I can save $1,000 a month, earn 7% of my savings, and I already have $5,000 saved. Okay, now we're going to go through our live demonstration. So here we have a Texas Instruments BA2 Plus calculator. Which is a type of financial calculator. The first thing I'm gonna do is show you these main five buttons that I'm talking about. So these are got the numbers down here, turn it on and off up here, and it's these. It's the N, the I over Y, the PV, the payment or PMT, and FV for future value. So we've got FV with future value, PV present value, I over Y is the interest rate, and N is the number of periods, and PMT or payment is any cash flow throughout the annuity or time value of money problem. Okay, so let's go through our example. Now, our first example was to calculate the monthly mortgage payments on a 30-year loan that was $300,000 at a 5% interest rate. So all you do is, all right, so let's turn it on. We'll start with future value. So the future value of a loan will obviously be zero because once the loan's finished, it will be, there'll be nothing else to pay. So you push zero, and then the number first, the value first, and then the button. That sets future value to zero. The payment is the one we don't know, so we're gonna leave that blank. The present value, so it's a $300,000 loan, so 300,000, so have I got that right? No, looking at the camera. And then we press $300,000 present value. The interest rate is 5% annually, but here's the trick. So because we've got to work out the monthly payments, not annual payments, we need a monthly interest rate, not an annual interest rate, but a monthly interest rate. So what we do is we get the annual rate, which is 5, and then we simply divide it by 12 months. And then we've got the monthly interest rate there. Press I over Y to create the interest rate. And then we have the number of periods. And again, we've got a 30-year loan, but we want monthly payments. So what we have to do is we have to work out the number of months in 30 years. So we go 30 years times 12 equals 360 months. And we'll put in the N there. That's the number of periods. And now we've got the four inputs, correct? Well, we've deduced them and entered them. And then you push this compute button. So you see up here, CPT will be compute. And then you press payment. This is a missing value that we're trying to work out. And we work out the monthly payment is $1,600. Oh, I beg your pardon. And the monthly payment is $1,610.46. And there you have your example. Okay, now for our second example. Now it's important to remember that from the previous example, we'll still have all the values saved in our five time value of money buttons. So second, clear function. Now our question is, how many years to save for an $80,000 car if I can save $1,000 a month, earn 7% of my savings, and I already have $5,000 saved? So our future value, FV, is going to be $80,000, because we want to withdraw $80,000 from a bank, set that as a future value. Our payment is $1,000 a month, but we're asking for how many years it will take. So we have to multiply that by 12. $1,000 a month is $12,000 a year. Now it's important that you make this a negative. So push the plus minus to make a negative $12,000, because we're going to withdraw $80,000 at the end, so we which is a positive number, so we have to have the deposits as a negative. Now our present value is $5,000 saved, so $5,000, and that's a negative number, so we're going to deposit that, so that it's a present value. Our interest rate is 7%, so 7 over y, and then we have all of the inputs, and then we do compute number of n, and it should take 5.2357 years, or 5.24 years. Okay, and finally, I mentioned a bonus tip. This is how to avoid the dreaded error 5. So we've already mentioned it or shown how to do it, but watch this. Okay, let's say we have a problem. So we've got 100 as the present value, and we've got 1,000 as the future value, and we've got 50 as the payment, and we've got 10 as the interest rate. Compute error 5. Oh no! If you're taking a test, this is really going to throw you. So what's happened here? Yeah, and this like, no matter, even when you know how to fix this, you're going to do this like all the time. It's just part of life. But at least you'll know what's going on, as opposed to being freaked out when you see it. So what's happened is that we haven't changed any of our inputs to negative, so they're all the same direction. So our future value was a positive number, our payment was a positive number, our present value was a positive number. Too many positives made it crash, because time value of money, they should be revert, like they should be alternative ends of a transaction. So at one point you put money in, at another point you take money out, or at one point you take money out, and at another point you put money in. So we should be able to fix this by changing our future value, perhaps to a negative. Now, if I remember what our future value was, I think it was, let's just set it to 1,000. Oh, so let's clear that. Now the memory should still be in there, and we'll do 1,000. Make this a negative number to show that, so we take money out, and then as positive numbers all the way, and then we'll put money back in, which is a negative, at the end. Set that as our future value, and this should fix the problem. There we go, we don't have the dreaded error 5. Okay, so to get rid of the error 5, make sure that it balances, as in cash flow is coming in and fat cash flow is coming out. Okay, that was your bonus tip.
Okay, that's it. I hope it helped. Best of success. If you enjoyed the video, please share or subscribe. Watch another one of my tutorials now. You can do that all via the buttons that'll be popping up on your screen. Or I'd even just appreciate a thumbs up if you could give me that. And finally, please comment below if anything needs clarification. And please comment below if you want to stir up a discussion with me or your peers. Thank you very much.